Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. First of all, a very happy new year to all of you. Today, I am going to show you how to install CodeBlocks. And after that, I am also going to show you how you can easily write a simple Hello World C or C++ program and how to run and compile that within our CodeBlock. So, you know, do watch the video till the end. I can promise you will be learning a lot of new things. And I have also started a couple of channels. So, in Geeky Syntax, I am posting coding related videos. If you want to learn more about coding or programming, then you need to subscribe this channel. And I have also started one vlogging channel. So recently I have been to Kashmir, so I have posted one dal lake video. So if you're interested, you can also subscribe my vlogging channel as well. So now, without any delay, let's start our video. So we need to download CodeBlock. So for that, you need to just simply search over here CodeBlock and click on this CodeBlock download, and you will get this www.codeblocks.org as our first search result. So here you need to just simply click on download, and when you click on download, you're going to redirect to the official site of CodeBlocks. So this link I'm going to put right in our description, so you can always go to that link to navigate to this site. And once you are here, you'll be able to see this download the binary releases. So you need to click on that. So once you click on that, you'll be again navigate to this page. So here, if you scroll down, you'll get Microsoft Windows. So under Microsoft Windows, you can see we have lot many files, right? So from here, you need to download this CodeBlock-20.03 MinGW setup.exe. You need to download this one itself. If you are downloading some other else, like if you are downloading only setup, so that will contain only the setup of CodeBlock. That will not contain any compiler. So if you just download only setup, your program or the C or C++ program that you are writing are going to be failed. It's not going to be run. Okay. You need some sort of compiler. So that's why we need to download this CodeBlock 2020.03 MinGW setup. This MinGW over here is basically our compiler. Alright, so this is very, very important. So here you need to just simply click on the sourceforge.net. You can also click FossHub, totally your choice. So you'll be navigated to the sourceforge.net page, and here you can see we have CodeBlock, and your download will get started shortly, and you can see it has rightly started downloading. So you know, let's wait for some time, and you can see that our CodeBlocks is rightly downloaded over here. So you just simply click on the setup in order to install it locally on your system, and it will tell you that the app that you are trying to install isn't a Microsoft verified app, which is totally fine. And you can just, you know, simply click on install anyway, and you can minimize your browser. So this will ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply hit yes, and there you go. You can see CodeBlock is rightly open. So this is the welcome note of a CodeBlock setup. Just simply click on next. So this is our license agreement. You can always read the license agreement and click on I agree. And this is what it's going to be installed. So as I was talking about, that you need one compiler. So here you can see this MinGW compiler shoot is actually will get installed along with our CodeBlocks. So that's why it is very important to, you know, download the right setup. So here you need to keep everything default. Just simply click on next. And this is where our CodeBlock is going to be installed. So on our program files directory, it's going to create a CodeBlock directory, right? And you can see that it will take 531 MB of space, okay, which is fine. Again, click on install, and there you go, our installation has rightly began. So this will take some time, you know, about a couple of minutes. After that, I'm going to again come back to this video. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our CodeBlock is almost installed, and it is telling, do you want to run CodeBlocks now? So you want to run CodeBlocks now, I'll demonstrate, you know, a simple C program. So you need to open CodeBlock first. You can also open CodeBlock by just simply double clicking on the shortcut that is there on our you know, desktop. And here you can see that compiler auto detection. So they have recognized this GNU. Yeah, GCC compiler, so status is detected. So that is what I was again talking about. So you need to have, you know, a compiler. If you don't have any compiler, then here it will show that no compiler detected. Now it is detecting that we have GNU GCC compiler, which is MinGW only. All right, so just, you know, simply click on OK, and click on next over here, and there you go, completing code block setup, finish. And our code block is also opened over here. So let's maximize it. And here I'll just, you know, click on this create a new project to create a new project. You can also, you know, close this. You can go to file and you can here click hover over new, and from here also you can create a new project. All right, so that will also open the same window. So from here I'm going to go to files and I'm going to click on the C or C++ source code. So just simply double click, click on next over here, and here I'm choosing C. You can choose C++, whatever language you want to use, totally fine. Let's choose C, click on next, and here you need to give a file name. So let's, you know, click on this triple dot, and here let's create a new folder. So I'm going to click on this and I'm going to write C prongs, so C programs. So I'll just simply open that folder, and here I'm going to give the file name as prog.1, right? And it's going to automatically set to .c. If you want to change with .c++, then you need to select C++ there. So here it would have been showing .cpp. All right. So just, you know, simply click on save over here and click on finish. And there you go. You can see that our prog1.c program is rightly opened over here. So here let's write a C program. So I'll just simply first forward this. So here is our hash include stdio.h. Then we have a main method and we have a print hello world over here, and we are returning 0. So 0 we need to return because this is int main. So you need to return something. So yeah, so that's the program. You can just, you know, after writing this, just simply click on this save, and then if you click on this run, what it's going to do is it is going to tell you that do you want to build it now. Yes, we want to build this program now and we want to see the output, and here you can see the output, right? The hello world is rightly shown over in our console. So in this way you can easily install code blocks, and you can, you know, simply create a file. If you want to create it in C++, you can do the same. The process is different. So on that place where we have selected C, we need to change with, you need to select C++, and you need to write C++ code snippet over here, right? And then again the same process, you need to save the file, you need to click on run, and you can see the program that is running, showing the output in our console, right? So that's basically all about this video. As I have told you in Geeky Syntax, I'll be posting a lot of coding and programming related videos. So please do subscribe this channel. And if you are also interested, you can also subscribe Geeky Script blogging channel. I'll be putting both this channel link in right in our description. So thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.